And you're very welcome back. And on screen, you can see umpire Elaine Bankier getting proceedings underway for this women's singles. And the young Scot, Holly Newell, I think still 17 and still in school, against a more experienced campaigner from Switzerland, Sabrina JAQUET. You would know a lot more about Holly than I would, Dan, and one for the future?
Yes, she definitely is. She's a very talented girl. She's got a lot of good shots. The one question against her might be mentally, and it's not that it's keeping her concentration long enough. But, I mean, in an arena like this, I'm sure she'll be up for the challenge today. And I'm sure she'll acquit herself very well. But she's against a strong opponent, and it's only going to be of benefit for her for the future.
As if we pan out, we'll look at the order of play again. For today's play, you can see, pick out your favourite match. We've already seen Kwok against Wang, and now we have JAQUET against Newell. Pistepong and Rapiskin women's singles coming up, and then the big one from a Scottish perspective, Gilmour against the classy Rong Schaffer, the Chinese player who spent many years in Denmark and now lives in America. And then the men's doubles, as the girls warm up. Sabrina JAQUET, world ranked number 50. Good results for JAQUET. Has been a very consistent performer. Certainly a woman who had been very inconsistent for a lot of her career, but the last year, last 18 months, has seen her play at a lot higher level with a lot more consistency. Runner-up at the Italian International in 2013, quarterfinals in Turkey and Sweden, quarterfinal at the Polish Open, all challenge events, semi-final at the Brazil Grand Prix, obviously the same level as we're playing here, and last 16 at the Bitburger only a few weeks ago. So has taken JAQUET inside the world's top 50 for the first time, against a completely inexperienced teenage Scot with no world ranking and very little senior experience. Interesting.
Yeah, but she doesn't lack confidence, and she'll be out there. Holly's not afraid to play anyone. She'll be out there thinking this is a chance, and she'll just give it 100%. She'll
Ladies
go for
and
it.
Gentlemen,
I just hope she's
right,
not too nervous
JAQUET,
in this huge arena. But she played very well last night, so hopefully she's a little bit more used to it than just coming in cold.
Yeah, beat Anne Tran, the young French girl, just out of juniors, played in the World Juniors last year, and beat Anne in three games. Tran, more of a mixed doubles player than a singles player, but it was still a good win for Holly because she really had to dig deep mentally to come through that game. But certainly this... a different kettle of fish against JAQUET.
Service over.
The steely-eyed JAQUET.
1-0.
Who have seen in recent past, beat some quality good players, and has really developed as a player for Switzerland over the last 18 months.
2-1.
Of course, qualified for the London Olympics by virtue of her quarter-final appearance at the European Championships in 2012. Just edging out Jeanine Ciccoghini in the very, very last qualifying week to get into the Olympics for Switzerland.
Halt. Service over.
That was better from Holly there. She didn't start very well.
She
looks nervous to me. The feet aren't flowing at the moment. But once she gets into the game,
service over.
We'll see. And that's, she's definitely nervous. That's a poor error at the start of the game. Not getting your low serving.
probably crucial for Holly, though, was the game yesterday. You know, that chance and the opportunity to feel the environment and get used to the arena.
Absolutely. Jackie's just hit a straight reverse hit there. Went out with the drift.
It was out. Service over.
I think that's John Dinneson, the coach for Switzerland, moved from Austria. Spent 5 or 6 years at the as Austrian head coach. And now in Switzerland. And of course, our own Ray Stevens behind Holly. Ray will be joining me here later in the commentary. And if you're lucky, you might get Ray and Dan together for an hour.
No, you don't want that.
Yeah. Oh, that was called out.
I thought that was in.
Yeah, certainly thought that was in myself. Not too many arguments from Sabrina. You might see it on the replay.
It certainly was close, but it looked from here as if it was in, but...
One of those ones, Dan.
Yeah. Line judge, thankless task.
And even more difficult in these earlier rounds where you're having to judge the full length of the line.
Absolutely.
Five, six.
If Holly can just settle, she's got the shots to worry anyone. She's got some genuine, real quality strokes. She can just relax and play the way she can. We'll see a very good game.
Service over. 7-5.
You tend to see with these younger players, there certainly is no fear.
She doesn't seem to show it outwardly, but just watching her feet at the start of the game, she looked a little bit apprehensive.
Service
just trying
over.
To do too much there.
Six,
she just needs to make
seven.
Sure it's in, make her work. That's clever there from Jackie, just playing her twice to the same area at the front of the court. And especially with a young player, they often don't have the leg strength. When she pushes out, she'll push out fast, and then it's just to go back into the same area. Very clever.
9-7.
Jacquet, 4 points in a row for the Swiss number one.
Yeah,
and that's what Holly needs to learn. She's got the girl at the back of the court, full extent at the back of the court, and she should be hunting the front of the court. You just don't move, but your weight should slightly be tilted. You're looking for the front of the court all the time. And then she's getting beat with it, which tells me she's looking for the rear of the court to go onto it early. She's got to force her by trying to hunt the front of the court to give her the shuttle in the air. And then once she gets it in the air, she can hurt her. That's a lovely cut there, played in slow motion.
Oh, nice wrist from Jacquet.
Service over, 11-8, interval.
And it takes the Swiss number one to the interval, 11-8. But a lot of positives from a Scottish perspective. You know, very difficult to come out here in such a huge arena and really such a major event at such a young age and be expected to perform like a seasoned senior. But she's acquitted herself quite well.
Yes, I think she may well quite be happy with that, because for me, I don't think Jackie can hurt her. It's not like I used to judge players, where do you not want to give them the shuttle? So the only thing that Jackie
seconds.
Is doing is she's outmaneuvering her. She's not beating her, but Holly's beating her with two or three shots. So for me, Holly needs to gain confidence from that, hunt the front, look for the net any chance she gets, and then when it goes up, use her range of strokes.
11-8. Play.
You see, that's a poor quality clear there. Flat 12, and short, eight. And it's punished at this level. In junior badminton, Holly may get away with stuff like that, but not at this level.
Is that time on the punch clear, oh, catching Jacquet just a little bit flat-footed. Nice footwork on the return from Jacquet, pushing Holly into that deep backhand corner.
13-9.
See, on the low serve there, Holly's serving it low and slow, and she's inviting, she's allowing Jacquet the time to deceive her. That's a poor error from Jacquet.
13.
But she's allowing her the time to deceive her. She needs to push her serve faster so that Jacquet can't use any disguise on the return.
Oh, nice block. Cross-court block from Holly.
Very good.
11,
very good play.
13.
Yeah, and Jacquet certainly caught off balance as she played that shot.
12, 13. Over. 14, 12.
The thing that Holly can't do is silly things like she's just done there, serving flat to her. She's too experienced a player. Holly needs to either serve low with a little bit of pace on it or put her high to the back. I don't think Jackie's got power that would hurt Holly from the rear of the court. She may have disguise and shots, but Holly needs to look for the front and dominate from there. Get the shuttle in the air. This is where she can hurt anyone. She's got lovely range of shots, providing she keeps them in.
15.
Yeah, that's the tricky part.
Absolutely. As it, otherwise, we'd all be world champions.
I'm certainly a world champion at hitting it out. There's not many that can beat me at that. And Holly Newell certainly got it back to within one.
I can't understand that. Holly's pushed her, 16, pushed her twice 12. Behind her, and she draws her way off the net. She's got to force Jacquet to give her the shuttle in the air. And the only way you do that with an experienced player is by, when you get it behind them, being up the court. The way Wang was up the court any time he had Quark in trouble in the last game.
17-12.
Oh, a little bit of luck.
Now, she was lucky there, but once again, she's got her taking it in the backhand, and she's drawing backwards in the court. She's moving back, worrying about the rear of the court. She shouldn't be. She should be making Jacquet clear by looking for the front.
Yeah, she seems to be leaving the front court wide open for those drops.
Absolutely, and they're not power drops, Mark, you know.
And they're not exactly not tight to the net either. You know, there's plenty.
It's just her weight at the moment, and when she's in her base, she's leaning back, she's looking to get on, she wants to get on the overheads 13, early, but she's 19. Young and doesn't understand that the only way that can happen is if you're threatening the front of the court.
Oh, a little bit of frustration now coming out. Game point
game
for Jacquet.
13.
Soft cross court from Jacquet for the winner, and you know, the experience of Jacquet coming through in the end really took her a little bit of time to figure out her opponent, especially when you haven't played somebody before. but frustration coming into the end of that game for Holly Newell.
Yeah, I think it's just the control of the shuttle. Jackie's control at this moment in time is very good, and Holly's isn't at the moment. But it's also the experience, and Holly not looking for the front of the court, because as we were saying, Mark, the drops that are beating her are not tight drops. They're not heavily disguised. It's just that her weight is going backwards.
Yeah, and you could see that in that last rally. She was in control of the rally, Holly, played the smash down the forehand side, but it was, again, not coming forward after the smash and leaving that complete wide open court for Jacquet just to play a nice soft cross for the winner. So something that she's certainly going to have to work on in her training.
And she's got power, so she should be trying to hit and come forward and look for the front.
Sabrina Jacquet already back out on court, ready to go. Ray Stevens just issuing the last few words of wisdom to Holly Newell.
Are you both ready? Second game. Love all. Play.
She does get very frustrated and can occasionally say and do things which are you don't really want to see, but that's just because she's young and her desire's there. She wants to be a winner. See, she can handle the power. That's what I can't understand. So that there shouldn't be any fear there. It's different when you're a young player and you're worried about somebody's power or a particular area of the court you can't deal with. But Jackie's just a very good player, and she has control of the shuttle there. A lovely serve right on the baseline. And she has quality shots. But she doesn't have weapons, as I would class it, that you had to worry about. You've just got to be up for it and look for the front of the court.
Love.
Once again, beat by another shot to the front.
The body language from Newell now, just getting a little bit, you can see she's becoming very frustrated. All part of the learning, of course, for a young player, dealing with the emotions. This time, nice power on that smash down the forehand side.
One,
but again,
four. You
could see Holly static after the smash and Jacquet going for the cross-court winner again.
And probably if it come in, Mark, it would have been a winner.
Service over. 5-1.
Once again, that's just trying to do too much with the spinning net shot there. She could have aimed up the middle and just kept it alive.
Service over.
Good disguise and that punch clear from Holly.
Yeah, and I actually thought she was looking for the front there for a change, so maybe the message that Ray's been giving her is getting through and we may see a change.
Service over.
Maybe not.
Maybe not, yeah.
Two.
I know that he will be reinforcing to her that she's got to get every shuttle back, get it back and make them earn what they get from you.
Oh, that looked to be going out. You can see Jacquet, if you just watch, you know,
seven,
she's more active
two.
And looking
Holly.
For the front court and looking
Holly.
For the short returns
Holly.
From Holly.
Over the net.
Yeah, and it's only 7-2 and Holly looks fed up and
yeah.
Just the body language is all wrong. Doesn't look as if she wants to be there instead of being keen and eager.
We've seen that particular shot
eight,
so many times
two.
In this match.
Yep, and I'm sure that's something that the coaches at work with her have to look at. She's hitting and looking to come in a straight line, and as soon as Jackie crosses it, she's beat.
Oh, everything going the way of Jackie. I've lost count of the amount of lucky net cords she's got at this point, but still.
But you know, you make your own luck, and as Gary Player used to say, the more I practice, the luckier I get.
Jackie digging that one off the floor.
Yeah, that's poor attitude now from Holly. She's got to use it as a learning experience and just keep working away, keep fighting.
11,
yeah,
two,
the attitude is all wrong now, Dan. Yeah.
Well, she just looks as if she wants off. Mm. And that's not how to become a top player. You have to have an attitude. You want to stay out there as long as you can and learn from your experience.
Yeah, I think she's getting a little bit of a telling off from Ray.
I'm sure she will be.
What do we see on screen? John Dennison and Sabrina Jaquet, and they're very calm. And now we see the opposite side of the net and a little bit more animated discussion going on. All the direction coming from Ray Stevens, and still the body language from Holly, just, oh, leave me alone, Ray.
I don't need this at this moment in time. Court one, but this is exactly what she needs.
Thank you, coach.
And he'll be telling her it straight, don't worry about that, because he knows that's what she needs at this moment in time. Get her refocused.
Play. Service over.
Three, that's a nice way 11. To come back out after the interval. The first two, three, 4 points are crucial here now. From a Scottish perspective. Better movement that time from Holly. Now, where is she? That's better.
Jesus Christ. Service over.
You seeing that's 12. Inexperience there, just three. Reading the body signals. She was looking for the cross cut, and because she thinks it's coming, she just moves slightly, and then Jackie plays something else, and she's beaten. Now I want to see her dig in here, because this is, I've seen her lose in the past and I've been there when she's won things, and she needs to show that fighting spirit when she's down. This is when you make your name if you want to get to the top. If you're playing players and they know you never give up, then you can win games before you even take the court. The body language is not good.
14-3.
Yeah, the game is over. The game is lost from a scoring point. But if she did show some character and some guts and determination, well, then that's something that you can take away.
Look at that. That's real skill and real quality. But she needs to show that all the time. Very early on to the shuttle at the front of the court there, and using a deceptive stroke to win the point.
Poor cross court slice.
5. From Jaquet. 14.
And again, you see Jaquet coming forward, expecting 15, the short return. 5. And all over it at the net, and literally all too easy.
And that is experience, Mark. You know, Jackie's got her in trouble. She doesn't let her off the hook. If Holly's got Jackie in trouble, she's looking for her to 16, clear it rather than putting 5. The pressure on the front.
But to me now, the worrying part here is not the quality of shot from Holly Newell. It's the attitude. The
Absolutely.
Attitude is all wrong now.
Yes. She's stopped trying here. It's one of those, I don't know if she feels embarrassed or whatever. She's got the skill. That's what she needs to understand. It's
6,
the desire
17.
And the attitude to stay out there she needs to get when things are going wrong, going against you. And Jackie, to be fair, has had every bit of luck.
Service over. 18.
But
6.
She's making her luck, and she's up for it. And look at the difference. She's purposeful in everything she does.
Service over.
Sabrina JAQUET, one of 18. Those really, really hard workers, completely dedicated and committed to the sport.
Yeah, you can see that when she's playing, because how many unforced errors does she make?
Eight.
Very, very few.
Service over. 19.
Yeah, Holly
eight.
Newell not even going for that. You know, she could have stretched and got a racket on that.
I'm sure Mr. Stevens won't be happy with this performance.
And in just 21 20. Minutes, it's match point for Sabrina
eight.
JAQUET, the Swiss number one.
Holly had it behind her there. That was a terrible shot from JAQUET to the front, and it still beat Holly. She made a mistake from
service
it.
Service over. Nine.
Uncharacteristically 20. Poor serve from Sabrina JAQUET, but I think she knows this one's in the bag. Yeah, and a comfortable eight. Drop winner coming forward for the handshake this time, rather than to take a return from Holly Newell and one-way traffic in the second game. We saw glimpses of what Holly could do early
match
in the first game,
Sabrina
but in the
JAQUET,
end, Dan, the attitude
13,
in the end was all wrong.
Nine.
Absolutely, and she should know, and I'm sure Ray would impress on her before she went out there, that she's there to learn. She's not. If you can deliver a performance, then who knows what happens. But it's the performance that's so important. You've got to get out there and you've got to compete and you've got to make them earn it.
You can see the final point on screen. The drop from JAQUET. Easy enough for Sabrina. It's the Swiss number one who goes through to the next round. We'll be taking a short break and we'll be back shortly with the next match on court. It'll be women's singles again from England. An unknown player to me. Tanapat Pistopong, do you know anything of this young English girl?
No, I'm afraid I don't.
Okay, against the more experienced but still very, very young Martina Rapiska, the Slovakian. I know Martina pretty well. She was in Dublin only 2 weeks ago in the European Mixed Team Championships qualifier. So that'll be our next match on court. Until then, we'll take a short break. Please do join us shortly.